Hello and welcome to the new series of Drishti IAS. I am Pooja Divedi, and in this segment today we are going to talk about the Treaty on Prohibition of Nuclear Weapons. This topic is important from the perspective of prelims and also important from the perspective of GS Mains Paper 2 and 3. So let's begin with the topics of discussion that we are going to look at. First of all, we will talk about Wien News. Then we will talk about the particular treaty which has come into force since Friday. We will talk about the Non-Proliferation Treaty as well. We will talk about the India's stance on the treaty, and we will talk about the impacts of the treaty. And in the midst of the segment, I am going to ask you a pre-based question, for which if you know the answer, kindly comment in the comment segment. So let's begin with Wien News, because India's stance is clear on the Treaty on Prohibition of Nuclear Weapons. It says that whatever bindings arise from the treaty does not stand for India. Now, India is standing against this particular treaty because it is believed that this particular treaty is discriminatory in nature, and it has come into force by non-dialogue between the nations. So if we talk about the treaty, it was passed by the United Nations General Assembly in the year 2017, and now it has finally come into force. And if we talk about the nations which led to the passing of it, kindly comment in the comment segment. So, 9 nations who were not believed to have it, and nations which were believed to have nuclear weapons, never supported this particular treaty. And if we talk about the volatility of the geopolitical situation right now, it is of course comprehensible that why do not the nations want it to be not come into force. So if we talk about the treaty, let's look at the salient features of it. You can note it down or take a screenshot. Now, it prohibits the deployment of nuclear weapons on national territory, and also help different states who want to prohibit the possession, acquisition, deployment, threat to use, or in fact the actual use or stockpiling of nuclear weapons. If this treaty will help those states who want to or which want to prohibit such actions. It also says that the state parties will also be obliged to prevent and suppress any activity prohibited to a state party under this treaty undertaken by persons on or on territory under its jurisdiction or control. It obliges the state parties to provide adequate assistance to individuals affected by the use of testing of nuclear weapons, as well as to take necessary and appropriate measures of environmental remediation in areas under its jurisdiction or control contaminated as a result of activities related to the testing or use of nuclear weapon. So, in totality, you can see thus that this treaty wants the different state parties to prohibit as well as prevent and also assist different individuals who have been affected by the use of nuclear weapons. And it also takes into account the environmental aspects, the negative impacts on because of the use of nuclear weapons on environment, it is taken into account. So if we talk about prelims, kindly be very careful about that. It does take the environmental impacts also into account. Moving on, it says that a state party must declare when joining the treaty whether it has eliminated a previous nuclear weapons program, currently has nuclear weapons, or holds other countries' nuclear weapons on its territory. So it obliges the different state parties to be very careful with the usage of nuclear weapons. It has weapons or it is developing the weapons. Everything with respect to nuclear weapons should come to the fore according to this treaty. So many countries who are believed to have a nuclear weapon possession, but they haven't declared it. Now, this because of this treaty coming into force, will oblige those states. Now, we have to see in future that is this treaty effective or not. This is for you to think. If a state has another country's nuclear weapons on its territory, when it signs the treaty, it must remove them. If it has its own nuclear weapons, it must eliminate them. Non-nuclear weapon states are required to have, at a minimum, a comprehensive safeguards agreement with the International Atomic Energy Agency without any sort of prejudice to any future additional agreements. So, all in all, what does it do? It's a pure disarmament of nuclear weapons. And if we talk about the original powers of nuclear weapons, that is China, US, UK, France, and Russia. They are the original five nuclear possessing countries. And of course, since many years, they are trying to strengthen the non-proliferation treaty because they think that they have the legitimate authority to possess nuclear weapons, and the other countries which are developing, such as India, Pakistan, China, they should not possess the nuclear weapons because they, of course, will want to build hegemony when it comes to psychological hegemony, that yes, we do possess nuclear weapons, so be careful of us. Moving on, let's talk about the warheads. Now, if you see this particular map, it will show you the 2020 estimated global nuclear warhead inventories. Now, United States has 5,800 inventory. So, of course, the hegemony the US has built is on its defense system as well as attack system. So, there is a hegemony that has been built by the US. There is a fear that has been built by the US, which is premised on the possession of nuclear weapons. Also, if we talk about Russia, look at that, 6,375 warheads. India has 150, China has 320, and Pakistan has 160. So, as you can see, that this particular region, this area is very volatile because India is surrounded by those two aggressive neighbors which possess nuclear weapons, right? So that is why India has all the rights and all the disregard or apprehension with respect to this treaty, right? Moving on, let's talk about the non-proliferation treaty. The treaty institutionalized the non-proliferation norm by delegitimizing proliferation, which is the production and transfer of nuclear weapons, fissile materials and related technology by the non-nuclear weapon states, while the recognized five nuclear weapon states, namely US, Russia, UK, France, China, can continue to possess nuclear weapons. So, according to India and according to other countries as well, they think that this particular treaty is discriminatory in nature because it doesn't give a universal picture. It is biased and it is skewed in favor of the original original nuclear possessing countries. So that is why India does not want to be positive on any such treaty that has come into being without any sort of dialogue, without universality, without the procedure of building trust. That is why India is against this treaty. And the treaty can be described to have three objectives if we talk about this treaty. The first one being non-proliferation. That means, except for these five countries, no other countries can engage in the production and transfer of nuclear weapons or nuclear weapon developing technology. And, however, NNWS criticized this treaty for having structural flaws and viewed it as an imbalanced instrument because of course we have already discussed about it, that it is skewed when it comes to possession of nuclear weapons, and that is why India does not want it to come into being. In the sense, it doesn't want it to be strengthened. Now, if we talk about the single most conference on disarmament, which gives the objective of complete disarmament, you have to name of which the conference of disarmament belongs to which convention. This is my second prelims question to you, right? So if we talk about the India's stand, if we talk about the stand of India. Now, India, as we discussed, that its geopolitical situation is such that it is surrounded by two most aggressive and very attacking in nature countries, China and Pakistan. So, is it really fine to say that India should not possess nuclear arms. Of course, in order to protect itself, it will definitely not agree to this concept that only 5 original nuclear weapon possessing countries should have it. So, if we talk about India's stand, generally India, after having its nuclear test in 1998, though it attracted a lot of sanction from the US and of course apprehensions from the world, the Western world specifically, it did have the no first use policy in mind, that India will not use it first, its nuclear weapons first, and it will not use it against the non-nuclear possessing countries. And this stand has been changed in the year 2019 when things start to escalate between India, Pakistan and China. So the defense minister back then said that now there can be a reverse of this policy, in the sense that circumstances will provide that India will use it first or not. And India says that such treaties, the treaty which we are talking about, the non-proliferation treaty, these are discriminatory in nature. They discriminate against those countries which have never been a part of the original 5, right? And aggressive neighbors, of course, this is an offshoot of the first explanation. We have aggressive neighbors, and North Korea is also on the verge of developing its nuclear weapons to an extent that it causes a destabilization in the entire area, in the entire region, subcontinent. Peaceful purpose. India will always use nuclear weapons as non-escalating structure. In the sense, it will just possess it. That means it won't use it first, but it will act as a deterrent for others to not use nuclear weapons against India. So peace will prevail. And economic expansion, of course. The safety, the technology for nuclear development. Nuclear development is not only related to nuclear weapons, but also other sectors such as energy sector. So for economic expansion, India does need those raw materials for building nuclear energy. Moving on, let's talk about the impacts. First impact of this treaty, the Treaty on Prohibition of Nuclear Weapons, is that it is de-escalatory in nature, in the sense that this will oblige the states to prevent and prohibit other states to use nuclear weapons, possess it, stockpile it, hoard it, transfer it. So it's de-escalatory in nature. Peaceful coexistence. When there is no nuclear weapon in the world, the chances of war will reduce. Not reduce up to an extreme level, but of course, the de-escalation will, of course, come down to an extreme level. Also, contemporary geopolitical period correctness, the volatile globe, when it comes to the trade war between the USA and China, China's overactiveness, over-aggressiveness in its own neighborhood, as well as Russia, China's bond when it comes to cornering of China, which pushes China into the arms of Russia. So the problem between India, Pakistan, China, US, UK, US, not UK, US, Russia and China is creating a political world, is creating a geopolitical world that is on the verge of war. So the time at which this treaty has come into force is really correct. Also, because this treaty has an environmental perspective, so that is very necessary. That environment must be preserved. It should not be at the cost of safety that the entire environment brings us back 30 years ago. Right? I'm talking about the COVID-19 pandemic. Because the humans intruded into the territory of the wildlife. That is why the wildlife which is needed to keep such viruses at bay, in check between different species. So, environment has been disregarded at large when it comes to war. So, that is also taken into account. Now, if we talk about the negative impacts of this treaty, I'm talking here with respect to India's actual stand. So what does it say? It says that the treaty does not constitute or contribute to the development of customary international law, nor does it set any new standards or norms the statement set by the Ministry of External Affairs. Here, I'm trying to tell you that India doesn't want to be a part of it because it's not verifiable in nature. India only wants to be a part of a treaty that has come through dialogue, through proper procedure for verifying that yes, these countries do possess and these countries do not possess any kind of nuclear weapons, and they are not skewed in nature. The nuclear treaties which are in existence right now are skewed in nature. And there is one more treaty by the name of New START Treaty, right? That has also been disregarded by the United States, right? So, New START Treaty also deals with nuclear weapons when it comes to two countries, Russia and US at large. So, that's it for today. Tomorrow we shall meet again with another segment. Until then, stay updated and thank you so much for watching.